So guys, we are back again with the part two of taking off the quantities of a roof, and we are going to look at what we had not done in the part one part of it. So if it is the first time you are watching this video, I'll share the link to the part one, taking quantities of a roof, so that you can have a connection to the from the part one, so that you can link up to the part two. So we are taking off the items that remained, that is the roof covering, the eaves and the verges, and then we do the downwater goods. Yeah, so if you are new to this channel, kindly subscribe guys. I can see those people who are watching who have not subscribed us are many, so kindly, if you are watching and you find it helpful, just subscribe. Now, we had gone through the drawing, so we are not going to go through the drawing again. So we are going to the items that we need for our part two. We are going to cover the roof covering, that is the tiles and the batten, and then chicken wire ridge cover, and then we have the field ends, and then number two, we have the eaves and verges, that is the runner, the bearers, T&G boards. Then we have the rainwater goods, that is the gutter and the downwater pipe. So we are going to start with the roof covering. So if we look at our plan here, we have 420 by 330 Mareb single lap tiles, and then these tiles, they are placed on a 450 by 40 batten, and then we have a lap. The lap between one tile and the other one is 75 millimeters. So those are things that we are going to do when we take off the, when we book the tiles. So let's look at the length of the tiles. So we need the length, and we also need the width. So we have our length here 12,600, and then the wall thickness 200, and then the projection 400, and then we have our now for the width, it's going to be the length, the span of the rafter, because that is how our wall, that is how our roof covering looks from one side, and we also have the other one from the other side. For the length, it's going to be 12,600. We add the walls, that is 400, and then we add the projection, that is 13,800. And then for the width, it's this span here for the rafter. We had from our previous video 4763, and then we add the fascia board, that is 250, that gives us 4813. So this one here is 4813. This one here is 13,800. So by two, because we have this one and the other side, so we book that one, and then we say 420 by 330 millimeter Mareb single lap roofing tiles with 700 millimeters end laps laid on a 50 by 40 millimeters treated cypress batten, upper sand polythene 500 gauge polythene underlay, and then upper sand chicken wire specification. So that is all for the roof. And then we go to the ridge cover. For the ridge cover is this one here. That is where we have our ridge cover. Our ridge cover is, let me highlight it. Yeah, this one here, that one is our ridge cover. So it's covering the entire length of the roof. So we just book the length 13.30, and then we say 25 millimeters half round ridge cap. And then we have these enclosed ends. We have these enclosed ends here and the other side. So they are 1 by 2, and then you say ditto for the enclosed end fill. So we go to the eaves and the verges. We are going to start with the fascia board. For the fascia board is that the finishing that goes along the length. So we need the length, and then we are going to, this is the length of the roof cover. So we subtract, say, 250, because it's not going to go up to the extreme end of the roof. So we are left with 13,700. There are two, this side of the length and this side of the length. So we say 13,700 by 2, 200 by 50, sorry, that is 50, 200 by 50 millimeters treated cypress fascia board. And then we go to the verges. When we're talking about the verges, it's the same as the fascia board, but now on the gable side, this side here. This is the verges. So we are going to take the length of the rafter. So there are 1, 2, and also times 2 for the other side. So it's 4.67 by 2 for this 1, 2, and then by 2 for the other side. We say little by the verger board. And then we go down to our next element. And then we have the runner. The runner is running from the where we have the wall. The length along the horizontal, our runner is always from this point, external up to external. We have a member that is running horizontally, it's a runner. So we book it also. So 12,600 plus 2,200, that gives us 1,300. So 1,300 by 2, and then we say 50 by 50 millimeters treated cypress runner plugged at the lintel. And then we go to the bearers. Now when we are talking about the bearers here, we are talking about this member here, that one is our bearer. So the bearer, they are running along the length horizontally here. We have like this one and another one, let's say here, and another one here along. So but the width of the bearer, let's say the length of the bearer is what is projecting. Now we had the width of the building here to be 7,000, and then 200 for the wall, and then 550 for the eaves. So now that is where we have our bearer. So this is 550 for the bearer. So we need to find how many are they along this horizontal length. How many are they? So the length is 12,600 from the wall here, and then we plus 1, and then we divide by, sorry, 12,600 divided by 600, and then we add 1, we find that there are 22 in. They are 22 in number, and then the length is 550, whatever was the eaves is 550, and then we less the fascia board and the girder, we are left with 425. So this is going to be our length for the bearer. So we book it in linear length 0.43, and then they are 22, and then we have by 2 because they are two sides, this side and the other side of the plan. So we go to the T&G boards. T&G boards, these are those boards that are placed now down here. Actually, this one here. This board here. Yeah. So it's covering the entire length of the roof cover. That is 12,600 plus 2,200 for the walls, and then plus 800 for the projection. But now we can less, maybe let's say 250, because it's not going to go to the extreme, and we are left with 13,700. And then the width of the soffit is also the width of the bearer, so it's 0.43, and then we say 25 millimeters T&G boarding on horizontal soffit of the eaves. So the same bearer here, the same T&G is also on the verges. So on the verges we take the length, it's also on the verges here. It cannot be seen from this drawing, but here in the verges we also have the T&G. So we take the length 4.76 by 2, and then by 2 we say little by the verges. So we go to the rainwater goods. The rainwater goods, we have the gutter. Now our gutter is the length of the of the roof covering, that is 13,800. Yes, and then we say 100 millimeters diameter UPVC gutter. Yeah, we have our gutter here. Let's look at it from the plan here. Yeah, so you can see the gutter is at the extreme end, so it's covering the entire length. And then we also have ditto for closed ends. Yeah, we have, so the gathers are how many? 13.30 by 2 on 1, 2 on the horizontal, and then we multiply by 2 for the other side. So we have 4 of them, and then ditto for the enclosed ends. Yeah, we need closed ends there, 1 by 4, and then in upper sand ditto. So the extra over, this is not ditto, extra over ditto for closed ends, and then we say upper sand ditto for forming hole, 100 millimeters diameter for downwater pipe. Let's look at the downwater pipe. We were told it is 3,000 millimeters from the ground level. And then this downwater pipe, it's supposed to form a neck here, somewhere here. And then we also are going to have a shoe down here. Yeah, so we also take care of those ones. So the length is 3,000 from the ground level. So the pipe length is 3.0. And then there are also 4, and then we say 75 millimeter UPVC downwater fixed by holder bolts. And then 1 by 4 extra over ditto for the swan neck, and then ditto for the shoe neck. So guys, up to that point, we have taken off the quantities of that pitched roof. Somebody commented that we should do a complex one. So we are looking forward to doing a complex one. Stay tuned, and thank you guys. Until next time, bye bye.